We want to take all this out.
Okay. Don't want. Okay, take out.
Is this scratching?
Sometimes.
Still scratch the ears.
Okay, ready? Okay, Saturday, April 25th, 2005. This pup came in with very much infected face, actually, last time. About 4 weeks ago or 6.
Sorry.
About 6 weeks ago?
Yeah.
It started with all these pimples on the ears, and then you can see they still come back again there. These pimples come back again. Did you see the ears? This one is okay. Okay, the face was full of pimples, like the young people having acne. It was really bad. But now it looks much better. But still on drugs, anti-itch and antibiotics. Okay, now you hold that. I just take out the stitches. One person hold the armpit.
Okay.
Now I take out the stitches. Now there was an inflamed lump here. I think it's due to the dog scratching. So the lump was removed. It was an inflamed abscess. It was not a cancerous or anything. This is only an 8-month-old pup. Now this is a very unusual case of having a deep spreading bacterial infection. Maybe the resistance is poor. But so far, it's not itchy really, right? Or slightly itchy.
Slightly itchy.
So it's just very itchy. So as to the cause of it, it's very hard to say. But this bacteria goes deep into the skin and causing the pimples. Now the histology shows that it was a ruptured epidermal cyst. So this histology just shows that beneath the skin there is a infection of the glands, sebaceous glands, and so most likely this pup is allergic to something which we don't know what it is, but one of them could be the plastic early on, and then the allergy was so bad so the pup keeps on scratching non-stop from the face, ears, and then one side of the body. Which side was it? The right side, right? It was scratching on one side.
Left side.
You can see the left side. Then he was scratching until the whole skin was full of pimples. Only one side. So that's why I diagnosed that it's due to the ears. Because the ears, inside the ears is itchy. And the pup can't control anymore. In fact, you can see this ear. It comes out again, the pimples. I thought it was gone early on. So one solution would be, unfortunately, I may have to open up the ear canal, the vertical ear canal, and drain out what's stuck inside it. They pour a bit more. So this is called deep spreading pyoderma. So we are still controlling it, but it's not fully cured yet. I think it's 2 months already, right?
Yeah, 2 months.
Not fully cured yet. Now this lump was probably due to the pup scratching the chest, and then there was an infected lump abscess. Other than that, you can see the pimples have gone off. And the skin is going back to normal. But you can see this from the biopsy. The skin was sent for histology, and the results show that it's epidermal, ruptured epidermal cyst, which actually the sweat glands has been infected. Yeah, you see these are it's healing very well actually. The new skin is kind of black. Why is it black?
I don't know.
It's due to scratching. Is it scratching?
I think the healing the of the
it's like that after she
after the
pimple it will become like that.
Now we just see the chin. The chin is bad at one time.
Yeah.
But still some remnants. Some leftover. Now which I don't like is this thing coming back again, the pimples on the ears coming back. So do you still use the mite wash?
Yes.
Yeah.
So it's very hard to tell exactly what causes it. So we just use anti-mite wash, anti-fungus, and the ear is most likely the main problem. So this thing can't be resolved, then I need to open up the ear canal. And let the ear have ventilation. Because sometimes the ear has no ventilation, so it's very itchy to the pup. very painful and very itchy. So, but actually the ear looks okay. There, no infection. So they have to wear the e-collar again until few more weeks. But there's no pain. Okay, can go home already.